Hello and welcome to episode 68 of Option LU. I'm Matthew Byrd.
And I'm Amanda Jacobsen. We're located here in downtown Lynchburg at Monument Terrace, located right on Church Street.
If you didn't already know, Monument Terrace was erected to honor all those who have fought and died in military action since the Civil War.
So while we go exploring around this area, let's get episode 68 started.
The main purpose of Option LU is to give you students something to do on the weekends, whether it's on campus or off campus.
Next up, Stephanie from Big Backyard shows us a local activity happening right here in Lynchburg that you actually might be interested in.
Hey, it's Stephanie here, and if you're looking for something fun and exciting to do, come on down downtown in Lynchburg Salsa.
Lynchburg Salsa is really fun for lots of reasons. You meet a lot of people, they're fun, they're lifelong friends. There's good music here. We have different DJs come in from around the city with instructors, so we learn a lot of different moves and we get to show them off. It's a fun time on a Friday night after a long, stressful week. And it's affordable, so I like doing it because it gives me a chance to express myself on my creative side, which I'm gonna have to do after weeks of science and history and math. And so I like to come here and just relax. But it's exercise and relaxing, it's relaxercise.
Lynchburg Salsa meets on Friday nights down at the Dance Theater of Lynchburg on 22 Commerce Street. It's $5 to get in, and that includes all the social dancing and the beginner lesson. If you choose to do the intermediate lesson and are of that level, it ranges from about $7 to $10 depending on the instructor, because we do bring professional instructors in from other towns and states a lot of times, so it'll vary on the price there. The lesson is at 9 p.m. and it lasts an hour, so for the beginner lesson, you don't have to know anything. It's great for first-timers, that's what it's geared for, so if you don't know how to dance, have never danced, not a problem. Then there's social dancing for you to practice what you learned afterwards from 10 to 12:30. We will sometimes bring a guest DJ in along with different pro instructors, so we advertise those events, they're a lot of fun, bring a diverse culture in.
Now that you've experienced Lynchburg Salsa for yourself, come on down next Friday night. And I'm Stephanie, reporting for Option LU in your big backyard.
You may have noticed some changes around Liberty University's campus lately.
But before we give too much away, let's catch up with Michael from Artistic Liberty.
Hi, I'm Michael Piliaveno with Artistic Liberty. As I'm sure many of you have noticed, Liberty University's campus has been inundated with life-size human sculptures. These plastic people can be seen doing everything from swinging on tire swings to, well, climbing out of floors.
Oh, I love them. I'm a senior here now, so I've been seeing these for the past 4 or 5 years, and they, I don't know, it's fun to see the imagination that the students come up with when it comes to them. My favorite one this year is probably the Rapunzel one that's in the middle stairwell. It's just cool to walk by. I don't know. I think stuff like that's so awesome. I wish I could do it, but, you know, not in the sculpting class.
Okay, for starters, we had to do sketches in order to develop our idea for what we wanted the pose to be. And then we had a live model pose for us, and we wrapped them in saran wrap, cling wrap. And then once we got a good layer of the saran wrap on, then we put packing tape over top of that. And once it was stiff enough to kind of hold its own, we'd cut it away. And we did it in several sections. Like, I did like this portion of the leg first, and then like the torso. And once you get all the pieces, then you just assemble them, make sure, again, it's good and firm, it won't bend or crease where it's not supposed to. We had lots of different ideas. If you look around campus, you'll see lots of different creative ideas going on, and I felt like I really had a lot of competition. One girl did Neil Armstrong. That was probably my biggest competition, and in my opinion, it's probably one of the best ones out here. But sculpture, I took sculpture 2 actually before I took sculpture 1, and I found both classes to be very fun. Love Professor Smith's way of teaching, his instruction style. He's very patient, very hands-on as far as helping out the students and everything. And I've loved both of his classes.
One of the unique aspects about these creations is that their exteriors are made entirely out of packing tape. The Department of Studio and Digital Arts puts these on display every fall semester, and this year they'll be running through the month of October. Keep an eye out as you trek across campus and see how many you can spot. I'm Michael Piliavento, and this has been Artistic Liberty.
This week, Dishes on a Dime shows us a very unique recipe.
That's right, and you can check out all of our recipes on our Facebook page if you'd like to use them in your dorm room.
Hey guys, welcome back to Dishes on a Dime. I'm Thalia Rampersad. So everybody loves a good movie night, so grab some friends, and I'm going to show you how to make this fun and easy snack called cookies and cream popcorn. What you'll need to make this snack are some bowls, some almond bark, a package of Oreos, a spoon, measuring cups, and of course, microwavable popcorn. So the first thing you want to do is you want to take out your popcorn out of the bag and just heat it up in the microwave. So after your popcorn's all popped, all you have to do is open it up and dump it in a bowl. So now that your popcorn's all in the bowl, what you want to do next is you want to take 12 Oreos and put those in a bowl by themselves and crush them up really finely. Before you put your almond bark on your popcorn, what you want to do is you want to take your crushed Oreos and spread it throughout the popcorn. Now, if you get too much of your mix, what you can do is you can spread it throughout two bowls so everyone at your party doesn't have to share one bowl. So after you're done putting your Oreo mix into your popcorn, what you want to do is you want to take your melted almond bark and you want to pour it into each bowl and mix thoroughly. After you're done mixing everything together, your dish should look just like this. And you can either eat it like this, or you can wait for it to harden a little while longer. Altogether, this dish costs us under $7. For Optionelle Use Dishes on a Dime, I'm Thalia Rampersad. We'll see you next time.
Hello and welcome to Optionelle U. I'm Deli.
And I'm Lenore. In today's episode, we'll check in with Big Backyard, Sports, Student Spotlight,
The Big Man, and then finally close it up with your Champion Connection. It's all coming to you
right now.
That was actually the big man on the phone.
Hey! I'm Sarah Wells for Optionelle U.
Well, obviously our tagline is for students, by students, and about students. And it really is. That just gives students like myself the ability to learn, just kind of thrown out there with guidelines, and you just kind of go for it, which is so awesome.
I've either edited my work, shot my work, or I've showcased, hosting on TV in the greater Lynchburg area.
You know, it's just good to keep people involved with Liberty University and what goes on around campus, and from a student's perspective.
And Optionelle U gives, students here, especially freshmen, and I know even as a senior, the ability to realize what's going on around them, that there's more to Liberty than just, their little bubble of their dorm or their little bubble of their circle of friends or their classes, but there's a lot of things that Liberty and Lynchburg has to offer them.
Having to come up with ideas every other week and then making them actually happen has created us to be really prompt and professional.
The students really have something to put out and show for what work they've done.
This week, Champion Connection brings you a very special story about a young married couple who were also Liberty alumni.
Tragically, Rachel and Aaron Horton were killed last year in an apartment fire, but now their dreams are becoming a reality thanks to the Lynchburg community.
Hello everyone, my name is Tahesha Moyes and welcome back to another episode of Optionelle U's Champion Connection. Today's episode will focus on two Liberty University alumni who passed away last year. Although they are no longer with us, their legacy lives on. On April 8, 2011, Rachel and Aaron Horton, 2007 graduates of Liberty, passed away following a fire at their Princeton West Circle apartment in Lynchburg. The fire occurred earlier that morning, and firefighters rushed to the scene after receiving a call just before 5 a.m. According to the fire marshal office, an electrical malfunction sparked, causing the apartment to burst into flames. Aaron Horton, who worked at Genworth Financial, was studying to receive his master's at the University of Wales. He eventually wanted to teach at Liberty University. Unfortunately, these plans were cut short. Rachel Horton worked at the Gentle Care Animal Hospital in Forest as an assistant for nearly 7 years. She truly had a passion for animals. Rachel would use money from her paychecks to buy prescription food for needy animals. Friends say she was always willing to go above and beyond her call of duties. Before her death, Rachel said that she wanted money from her paycheck to go to the families of the animals who couldn't afford surgery. A week after she told her colleagues this, she died. But in response to her death and the great work she has done for the animal community, the staff at the Gentle Care Animal Hospital started the Rachel Horton Compassionate Care Fund. Reporter Victoria Stamoulis has more information about this. Victoria?
Thanks, Tahesha. I'm Victoria Stamoulis here in downtown Lynchburg at the Paws and Purrs 5K 10K race in support of the Rachel Horton Compassionate Care Fund.
Rachel was one of my best friends, and she is one of the kindest people I've ever met. This fund was actually her idea, something that she wanted to do before she passed away. Her and Amanda talked about it about a week before she passed away. She just had so much compassion that people felt it when they were around her. You know, when they came into the clinic, when they would come into the clinic, she was always kind to them. She was always very special with the pets. She had a very calming manner about her. And I think with the fund, we just want to help keep that alive.
The Rachel Horton Compassionate Care Fund believes that no pet owner should be denied medical treatment due to financial reasons. With over 30 sponsors, this fund continues to grow, reaching pet owners all over the Lynchburg area.
We severely underestimated the size of the heart of Southwest Virginia. Almost immediately, we had large donations coming in. The money was starting to build up in our account, and we allowed the fund to grow in proportion with that. Initially, it was just supposed to be Gentle Care Animal Hospital. And as the money came in, we decided that we wanted to help all of the animal hospitals in the region. And we started putting together guidelines and principles so that we could help any animal in Southwest Virginia. And our goal eventually is to go national if we possibly can.
Thanks, Victoria. It's such a great thing to see people caring enough about Rachel's last wishes to create that fund. With the help of the Rachel Horton Compassionate Care Fund, families are able to enjoy the company of their pets for just a little while longer. If you would like to donate to the Rachel Horton Compassionate Care Fund or find out more information about them, call 434-534-9894 or visit rhccf.org. In order to keep the fund running, the Rachel Horton Compassionate Care Fund hosts various fundraising events throughout the year. This year, they hosted for the second time the Rachel's Paws and Purrs 5 and 10K benefit race. Alex Miller has more about this event.
Well, wag my tail and call me Sandy. I'm Alex Miller, and I'm here today with Honora and Susan, and we're at the Rachel Horton Paws and Purrs 5 and 10K run. Are you excited to run today?
Yeah!
All right, let's see what all is going on.
140 people, along with almost two dozen dogs, arrived at 7 a.m. to begin the race. Participants chose either the 5K or the 10K trail, but everyone involved got plenty of exercise. After the race, vendors offered the runners a variety of food, with pizza for the humans, as well as tasty biscuits for the dogs.
They're soft, they're good for 2 weeks in the refrigerator, and we have parsley cheddar carrots, peanut butter and carob, pumpkin harvest, and apple cranberry.
This is Mama Kia, and she's, you want to say hello?
So today she dragged me the first half of the race, and then I kind of led the second half. It's been good for her to socialize with a lot of people and other dogs.
After the race, there was an agility demonstration by the dogs, followed by a question and answer time with the K-9 unit from the local Lynchburg police.
The Paws and Purrs 5K is an annual event, so if you love puppy dogs, running, and getting up early, I hope to see you here next fall. For Option LU, I'm Alex Miller.
Thanks, Alex. What a great way to honor the family. That does it for today's edition of the Champion Connection. To read about more stories, be sure to pick up your copy of the Liberty Champion or log on to libertychampion.com. Thanks for tuning in and have a great day.
This week, Tech in 2 gives us an update on a very popular technology.
Let's take a look at the announcement of the brand new iPhone 5. Welcome back to another Tech in 2. I'm Matthew Byrd, your host here on Option LU. And today we've got an exciting announcement to make, and it's Apple's announcement, of course, about the iPhone 5. Widely expected some changes that they were going to make. Rumors were true. We'll talk about those today. Of course, if you've got any type of feedback or if you've had some hands-on experience with the new iPhone 5, make sure to tweet me, Matthew A. Byrd. Love to have your reviews. Love to put those up on the Facebook Option LU pages as well. But anyways, back to the big announcement. Of course, Apple came out, new iPhone 5. Bigger than that announcement was probably that we're finally getting a bigger screen, 4 whole inches. Now, it wasn't bigger as far as width, it was bigger height, which the main reason they said that they did that was so that it still fits in the palm of your hand, but it does allow you to have a fifth row of icons. So exciting news, you've got more icons on your home page that you can look at. They packed in a feature that I had been looking for, the LTE. 4G is its most commonly known. Long-term evolution allows you to get the higher speeds, a lot of times higher than your own home network, and that really improves something that was needed. It was still on 3G, even the iPhone 4S. A lot of people just didn't think it met the expectations because Samsung, Motorola, HTC had several models for 4G networks, both AT&T and Verizon, and that's really the push right now. Verizon and AT&T are trying to compete with each other on who's got the biggest and largest 4G network. Some other features to it, the camera is still 8 megapixels, but they've added a new glass in there, supposed to make it more resistant as well, and something cool is the panorama picture taken. Over the weekend, I had a chance to try that out on the iPhone 4S, which iPhone 4S and iPhone 5, I have the new panorama feature. Literally, hold the camera up, hit the picture to go, and you just swipe across until you fill up the whole frame, and it creates the picture for you. Really cool feature, really fun to play with. I did it in a restaurant with some friends, came out really neat on that. Also along with it, the redesign of it, it's not the pure glass anymore. They've made it more what's called the aluminum glass. So think of a MacBook Pro or a MacBook Air, if you got one of those, that type of surface where it's the glass and then the backside of it goes together. And then something really cool, the biggest feature I saw was a fingerprint resistant oleophobic coating. No clue what that has to do with anything, but look it up. I'm sure it's really important. So, you know, I wanted to let you in on that feature. Of course, along with the phone, they released their new EarPods. New design, supposedly fits in your ear a lot better, a lot more comfortably. I'd be really curious to get your guys' feedback on that because it's coming with the new iPod Touches and iPhone. So if you get one of those, tweet me, post on our Facebook page. I'm curious what you think of that, and I want to see your feedback on it. Anyways, that's been your Tech in 2 for this week. We are here, Tech in 2, to give you feedback on technology you can use in the classroom and around campus at Liberty University. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Matthew Byrd.
For more information on Option LU, make sure you check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/OptionLU and be sure to tweet at us at Option LU.
Don't forget about our brand new blog, optionlu.tumblr.com. You can see all kinds of behind the scenes videos and pictures, especially about how Option LU is made since it's by students, for students, and about students.
For episode 68, I'm Amanda Jacobsen.
And I'm Matthew Byrd. Have a great week. We'll see you next time.